instruction. So we will require an interface between the user and the hardware to communicate with each other and perform a specific task or give any specific instruction to the computer. These instructions or this interface is known as operating system software. Why operating system software? Because in the last video already I have described what is software, and in software is classified into two parts. One is system software, another is application software. So what is system software? System software is a software that is required to run the system, whole system of the computer device. So operating system is the system software. So this is known as operating system software. Example, DOS, Windows, Unix, and etc. These are the operating system software. Now we will learn what is the need of an operating system software. So need of an system. So what is the need of an operating system? First of all, we have already learned that a hardware is of no use unless there is an interface between the hardware and user, and that interface is known as operating system. So first need number one, it helps run multiple software applications in a single system at the same time, thus saving our time. That means multiple application in single time. Suppose there is Microsoft Word, that is a software, and there is an inbuilt software that is calculator. Suppose we are doing a work in Microsoft Word, and at the same time we can work in calculator also. Like in our general life, we do any calculation, we using calculator. If we want to write anything, we write in a copy or any notepad. But in computer, we can do the both work at the same time using multiple applications. So our time is saved. And the next part. So next point, it helps with the allocation of resources to different applications. Suppose there is a Microsoft Word is a application software, and there is a game in your computer. Suppose resource means what? How much RAM or how much storage is present on your computer? Suppose you have 20 GB left in your computer, but you want to store a game that is a size of 30 GB. So resource is not enough. So you have to store a game below 20 GB. That is known as resource management. And resource management means what? Now you can delete some unnecessary files. Then your memory will move up to 30 GB. Then you can store a game of 30 GB in your computer. So your resource is manageable, or resource allocation is manageable by the computer. Now the third point, it can share a single resource hardware. saving hardware resources. The first point I have told you, we can use multiple applications on a single user or single interface. So when we use single multiple application, we use only one hardware. Suppose when we use calculator, we use the same keyboard. When we use the Microsoft Word, we use the same keyboard. We don't use different keyboard for one for Word, one for Excel, one for PowerPoint or one for calculator. We use the single hardware. So we don't have to buy multiple hardware. This is a very important thing. Now the last part, it helps sharing a system with multiple users. Suppose in our lab there is a single computer. This computer can be used by a student also. This computer can be used by a teacher also. So when student will give the instruction individually to the user, when teacher will give the instruction individually to the user. So there are more than one user in a single resource or single operating system. Right? So these two are multi-user. Because more than one user is accessing one computer or one operating system. Got it? Now we are moving to our next topic, that is features of an operating system. So
operating
system. So what we have learned? That a hardware of a computer cannot function on its own. A user needs to, user requires to need give any instructions to do the specific work. So an interface is required between the user and the hardware. This interface is known as operating system. So the second part we have.
Love this one.